Good afternoon, lads, ladies, pirates, players, real people behind the prop house stats. There's something that makes me very happy, which is that how progressive this team, this group of players have been over time. When new players are able to join, they are able to join a guild knowing that it will treat them in the most wonderful and fair manner. We've got so many players that are participating in funding the perks. And you have so many players that are willing to give troops that are, depending on their device availability time, they are also willing to score on a regular basis. No matter how small. Look, lad, little lad, look, little lad. Yeah. No matter how small. Look, he hasn't received no troops, but still been playing, smashing it out, you understand? Little lad. Noisy boy. That's the one. I'm the one that's making the noise, not you. Yeah, so you can see. This is what makes me happy. Yeah, look, potashed. But look, making a little guild tip there, you know, that I'm saying. There's a little pool of water right there, that's so cute. Take a little swim there. Yeah, so you can see the progress that's happening. Now I'm going to show you something. It really upset me recently. And there's some things in life that's going to scar you. There's some things that will bring you comfort and joy. This player here has been moving around so many guilds. This player has been to more guilds. I'm not going to say more than what I've been to, but I'm telling you, this player keeps moving around. I don't know what you're doing, what you're doing. This, and it's not about you. So what I'm trying to show you is, look, there's players that come into the game, and it's like, I'll give you an example, yeah? This is how people reverse what right is into wrong, or what's wrong into right. And the way they do it is, there's people that value life, whether it be of animals and creatures, and then they're told in some sort of reverse type of a psychology that obviously when it's time for them to say, like, eat chicken or whatever. In some countries, they only take the life of that chicken once it's time for them to actually eat the chicken, if you know what I mean, you know? But there's some countries that will inject the monkeys of chemicals into these creatures, and they'll keep them stored inside of warehouses for months. So that creature didn't have to even die at that time, you understand what I'm saying? And it could have lived a more better, healthier, longer life without being injected so many times. And so it's easy to turn around and say to people, oh, your people, they take the life and they slaughter animals and stuff. But they don't. The thing is that in their countries, they're only doing it when it's time to deal with eating or dealing with the creature. Here, where we're living in this, wherever we are, they're doing it like they're already taking the creatures. They took their life months ago and they left them inside of storage places. Look, this is what I'm talking about. Look, yeah, 97 days, yeah, offline. But no, Texas Angies, yeah, I'm talking to you today, yeah. I talk to you today. You need to stop kicking people. I know you got a really high score on the leaderboards this month, but there's no need for you to kick players just because basically this guild here, they want to be, I think they want to be above 250 PR. That's all their thing is. And if you're not above the 250, they're going to kick you. So this guild here, you could be off for 97 days like a like the chicken that they have for the KFC and wherever, you know, and they would just, they just want you to just have the higher PR, and that's it, you understand what I'm saying? But there's the, what kind of progress is that? I don't understand it. Because so when I went there, that's what really upsetted me. I didn't understand why you were just kicking players for no reason. There's one player that came back into the guild and got upset and said something because Dad had to be right. You can't kick players just for nothing. That's unbelievable. So that's why it upset me. And there's some things in life that are going to upset you. I'm telling you, that was so upsetting to see that. Players, peaceful players were being kicked. It was unbelievable. I could not believe it. And I'm really happy with the progress that is made here at the Memes Guild. They would hold on to some certain specific players, but at the same time, they won't kick players. You know, unless you're not supporting the team, like with your Rumble, at least score. You know, like even if it's small points, look. I'll show you, look. Say, Mick, yeah? Playing for 7 days, 26, 32 battles, not bad. Still plays quite well. Logs in. You need 8-9 hours sleep anyway, you understand? You got your own thing to do, whether you're going to college, whether you're going to school, whether you're going to work, whether you're doing an apprenticeship, whether you're looking after elders or younger people. It's all about your device availability time, depending on what part of the world you're in, what if you've got Wi-Fi, whatever the situation, hotspots or whatever's. You're trying, and you receive troops. Yes, so it shows. The progress does show, and it takes time. But you can't kick players because they've got a lower than 100 PR. You have them and made 250 PR. It's unbelievable. And that really upset me recently. And that's what I wanted to talk about. I just wanted to discuss. I wanted to explain it. So everyone knows it. Everyone knows what level of the understanding in gameplay that the Unique Rebel is traveling through at the moment. I'm happy with the normal trend of any type of a gameplay is that game always needs something a little bit fresh to come into the game. I will always maintain just one thing. I know whether this game will survive or not, whether the efforts that have been put into this game, whether they will be continuing to be neglected or not, or maintained. This game would be far better, maybe, if there were small adjustments made, even not major adjustments, even though I'd always say, oh, we need 2 levels of cannons and 3 levels of walls and 2 different more storages. We need skins in this game. We need new Legendary Pirates. We need a new map. I could say so much, but what? How much of that is gonna, do you understand? Like, I don't want to use my heart no more. Because you know when you've been hurt enough, like, you know, it's just one of those things. It's important that I just, do you know what it is? Mama didn't raise no idiot, bruv. This is one of them ones. And I don't expect anything too solid from whoever's helping to run this game. All I know is, what I'd like to do, it would be nice in futures to give away like codes to players, people, for a few gems per week. I like to hand out codes, you know, and just keep the game interesting, keep the channel interesting. I'd like to do things, you know, I'd like the people that are running this game to deal with some percentages, with outfits, with certain specific troops, with certain specific legendary pirates. They could adjust them, they could like give us half troop recruitments for the weekends. Even if it's just for like the troops that we give when players ask for troops and we give them troops in the guild ship. If we could, like, after I've given someone troops, maybe the troops that I gave could just be half troop recruits, like from weekends. From maybe from 6 PM on a Friday to midnight on a Sunday. You know, like one of them ones, like, I know the time zones will be different around the whole world. So we keep it GMT, you understand what I'm saying? There's so much that can be done with the game. But anyway, it upsets me to see certain specific guilds that remove players without a decent, a reasonable way. You can't kick active players. I just don't understand that, Texas Angies. It doesn't matter to me which guilds you were in before. It doesn't matter to me where you're from. All that matters to me is the way you've been playing your game. And it really upset me to see that you'd remove players for a reason other than, there's no reason. How could you remove players that are active and progressive? You just kicked them. I was there, I saw it happen. And it was unbelievable. Watch this player here. This player will not last in his guild. He just joined, yeah? This player's gonna get removed within minutes, hours. Not because the player's inactive, because the player is not gonna get the PR ego up to the standards that they've set this guild. It's unbelievable. When I saw that, let me be warned. My job is to tell you to just be warned. Allow me to go. Wish you all well wherever you may be. Keep smiling, keep shining, keep rising. For the boredom of the gameplay in Germans as they evolve. But most importantly, the reality of the real life. Get back to the game.